Welcome to tutorialsinhand.com. In this video tutorial, we are going to learn about Java program to replace an element in array list. It means we are going to replace the existing element with some other element. So for now, we have got our list, which is the name of the days. The objects are of type string as shown in the generics of the type list, which is an array list. Okay, so we have already got our days. We want to replace any of them with some other object. So how it can be done? First of all, let's print this list, that means the status of the current list. So this is the status of the current list which you are seeing over here. At index 0 we have Sunday, at index 1 we have Monday, at index 2 you have Tuesday, and so on. So this is the current status before we have performed any operation on this list. Now our task is to set an element or set an object that contains some other value than the existing one. So suppose you want to replace Sunday with some other value, say holiday. Just for fun, there is nothing logical, so just write list day, which is the name of the list, and then on it invoke the method set. And when you invoke the method set, you see there is an int index where you will provide the index at which you want to set the value and the element itself. That means since it is having a string value, so you are getting the suggestion for a string element and you have to provide some string value. For now we want to replace Sunday with holiday, so we will provide here a string object holiday. And when you invoke this set method, what exactly happens? Just check there. It will take a parameter. First parameter is index, that is integer value. Second parameter is element itself, which is the object that you want to place there. And this method set will return you the previous element that was present at that specified position. So this is all set method is going to do, and it will also throw these kind of exception if there is any kind of errors that is mentioned over here. So for now, just set this one. By default it is giving you the index 0. We want to replace at index 0 itself, that is Sunday should be replaced by holiday, right? So we are replacing Sunday with holiday. And if we print the list after this, so we will print the list after update. That means we have updated the value at index 0 with string holiday. Okay, so let's execute this one for instance and see what we are getting. And here we get the output. So this was the initial list that we had, this one, and after that we have updated this list at index 0, and thus after update you see Sunday has been replaced with holiday. That means we have set Sunday as holiday. That means we have set index 0 with value holiday, and that is what is being reflected at this place. You are getting holiday at index 0, right? Now since we saw that it returns the element that was previously present at the specified position, that is 0, and we are aware that at 0 initially Sunday was present, so let's check whether it returns that or not. So Sunday is a string object, so we are going to take the value within a string object or a string variable named day, and let's print the day. So this is day, and give one comment so that we can understand what is exactly this day. So we are going to give comment element replaced. So this is the element that is getting replaced, would get printed on the screen. So this time if we print, we will also see that the element that has been replaced is Sunday. So let's execute and see. You are seeing the initial list which is getting printed from here, line number 18, and then you are performing the set operation on index 0, and you are setting the index 0 with value holiday, and thus it is replacing Sunday with value holiday. And then you are storing the value that is getting returned by this set method. And as you know that set method returns the value that is initially present at index 0, which was Sunday. So Sunday is getting returned and is stored in this variable day, and we are printing it over here that element that is replaced is Sunday, and this is getting printed at this place. That element replaced is Sunday, and after that you are again printing the list. That is, you are printing the modified list, and the modified list contains at index 0 holiday, which is getting printed at this place. Now you can play around with this example and keep updating the index and set different values. For example, Sunday at index 1. So this time at index 1, Monday is present, and the list after update would have, instead of Monday, you will see Sunday at this place, and it will return which element is getting replaced, which is Monday. So Monday will be stored in this day variable, and when you print this day at this place, element replaced would be Monday, and updated list would contain at index 1, that is Sunday. So let's execute this and see what we get. See, the element that is getting replaced is Monday, and at place of Monday you are getting Sunday in the list after it has been updated. So hope you have understood how you can use this set method to replace or update the element at particular index. So I expect you have enjoyed this video tutorial. Please like and subscribe our channel to help us motivate. Thank you.